Ex abinos Domine Sancte Patro Omnipotens et Benedictus, et nite dimieri Sanctum Angelum Deum Decens, qui custodia copia codita visitat atque dependat omnes habitantes in nota vita per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Thank you. See you. is good. Sequentia Sancti Evangelii secundum Ioan.
Gloria tibi Domine.
In illo tempore cum sero esse die il luna sabbator, et fores essent clause iubi erant discipuli congregati propter metum iudeor. Venit Iesus et stetit in medie, et dixit eis, pax vobis. Et cum hoc dixis et ostendit eis manus et latus, gavis sunt ergo discipuli viso Domina. Dixit ergo eis iterum, pax vobis. Sicut misit me Pater et ego mito vos. Et cum dixis et insufflavit et dixit eis, accipite Spiritum Sanctum, quorum remiseritis peccata remituntur eis, et quorum retinueritis retenta sunt. Thomas autem unus ex duodecim, qui diditur didimus, non erat cum eis quanto venit Iesus. Dixerunt ergo ei alii discipuli, vidimus Dominum. Ille autem dixit eis, nisi videro in manibus eius fixurum clavorum, et mitam digitum meum in locum clavorum, et mitam manum meam in latus eius non creda. Et postie socto iterum erant discipuli eius intus, et Thomas cum mei. Venit Iesus Januis clausis, et stetit in medio, et dixit, pax vobis. Deinde dicit omnes, infer digitum tuum, et vide manus meas, et afer manum tuum, et mite in latus mei, et noli esse incredulus, sed fideli. Respondit Thomas et dixit eius, Dominus meus et Deus meus. Dixit ei Iesus, quia vidisti me Thoma credidisti, beati qui non viderunt et crediderunt. Multa quidem et alia signa fecit Iesus in conspectu discipulorum suor, quae non sunt scripta in libro hoc. Ec autem scripta sunt ut credatis, quia Iesus est Christus filius Dei. Et ut credentes vitam abeatis in nomine ei.
Thank you. translation of the Gospel for Low Sunday. At that time, when it was led that same day, the first of the week, and the doors were shut, where the disciples were gathered together for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in the midst and said to them, "Peace be to you." And when he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples therefore were glad when they saw the Lord. He said therefore to them again, "Peace be to you. As the Father hath sent me, I also send you." When he had said this, he breathed on them, and he said to them, "Receive ye the Holy Ghost. Whose sins you shall forgive, they are forgiven them. And whose sins you shall retain, they are retained." Now Thomas, one of the 12, who is called Didymus, was not with them when Jesus came. The other disciples therefore said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Except I shall see in his hands the print of the nails, and put my finger into the place of the nails, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." And after 8 days, again his disciples were within, and Thomas with them. Jesus came, the doors being shut, and stood in the midst, and said, "Peace be to you." Then he saith to Thomas, "Put in thy finger hither, and see my hands, and bring hither thy hand, and put it into my side, and be not faithless, but believing." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus saith to him, "Because thou hast seen me, Thomas, thou hast believed. Blessed are they that have not seen and have believed." Many other signs did Jesus in the sight of his disciples, which are not written in this book. But these are written, that you may believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that believing you may have life in his name. Today, Low Sunday, the octave day of Easter, we are glad to welcome Canon Post from Preston, and which allow us to have this Solemn Hymas. Although, as you know, the Institute would like to have Solemn Hymas anytime this is possible. Next Sunday, the 1st of May, second Sunday after Easter, also named after the Good Shepherd Gospel. This year we will celebrate the feast of St. Joseph, the workman. But the Good Shepherd Sunday is also an occasion to ask for humbly for your generosity to support the formation of our seminarians. In the seminary of Gricigliano, they are your priest of tomorrow. Thank you for your help, and you may find the special envelopes as usual at the back of the church, and if you wish, also the gift aid form. This afternoon, we are holding the 8th recital, organ and Gregorian chant recital. I would like to invite you to come and join, especially as the weather is nice and the church is not that cold. And if you can't make it, please use the technique to follow that on the live stream. Don't forget, in that case, even in the replay, to like, comment, share. Anything of that can help us. Two important things this coming week. Tomorrow, the Monday, the 25th, Feast of St. Mark, also known as the Major Litanies. This solemn cry of the Church to ask for the blessing of our field and country. So at 6 during the adoration, we will sing the Litany of the Saints, inviting you to join to this beautiful devotion to ask the protection from heaven. And Tuesday, the 26th, the transferred feast of St. George, protector of England. I invite you to come and celebrate this, our patron saint. I know that the feast is on the 23rd, but when it's full with a first-class feast, the church allowed us to transfer it to the next day. And Johanna, our patron saint, will have a sung mass in the evening. "They have pierced my hands and my feet. They have numbered all my bones. They shall look upon him whom they pierced. The name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen. My dear brethren, on this octave day of Easter, after a glorious and joyful celebration of the anniversary of our redemption, we are still invited to contemplate with a tender love our Saviour, victorious against death, sin, and devil, victorious by obedience to repair the disobedience of the first created man, victorious out of love of God and for his creatures, against the evil hate of Satan, who didn't know or believe that he was the Son of God, the promised Messiah, the one to come and accomplish any single prophecy about him. He was announced, we were expecting, we have been praying for 4,000 years, as we sing in our Christmas carols. And here he is, and he will never leave us anymore. He is above us, attached upon the cross at the top of our altar, and even outside, being above this area of New Brighton for more than 80 years until now. The victorious cross at the top of our dome being the highest point of our beloved country. We asked all along this journey of penance during Lent, while we were devoutly praying the Station of the Cross, we asked him to nail our hearts to his feet, that it ever remained there to love him and never more to leave him. We were deeply lucky all along this Holy Week and Easter Week to contemplate all the sufferings of our dear Redeemer through the reproduction of the Holy Shroud of Turin, exposed at the back of our church, showing us the immense love of our Saviour, who, being innocent, was taken like a lamb without voice before his shearer, so opened he not his mouth. In humility his judgment was taken away. His generation who shall declare, for his life shall be taken from earth, as we can read in the prophet Isaiah. Today, as everything has been consummated, and our Lord is now victoriously risen from the dead, we should, we can, we must humbly approach him to testify with our own eyes through the faith, the resurrection. Like St. Thomas, we contemplate the five wounds of Christ, the same wounds through which he suffered so much for the sake of most of us. Those five wounds that Jesus kept in his divine body after the resurrection as an evidence of the truth of his passion. And to also symbolize, to promise for all of us that all our pains, our prayers, our sacrifices will still be ours as part of our reward in our glorified body when we will rise again with Jesus at the end of the time. We can find several meanings in the five wounds of Christ, the hands, the feet, and the heart. It's my honor and pleasure to call back to your memory several of these. The five grains of incense that the deacon fixed into the Paschal candle during the consecration of the candle at Easter Vigil. The five crosses engraved in each altar stone. The five grains of your rosary beads upon which you say the Our Father. The five fingers of your own hand joined together to make a beautiful sign of the cross, starting and finishing each of your prayers, each of your days. St. Bernard de Clairvaux wrote himself a prayer to honor the wounds of Christ, Salve Mundi Salutare, praying the holy wounds of Christ one by one, and even adding two more. Adoring the feet nailed to the cross, adoring the knees upon which Jesus fell three times, adoring the hands nailed also to the cross, adoring the sides struck by the scourging at the pillar, adoring the breast hit by the soldiers, adoring the heart pierced by the spears in lunges, and finally, adoring the head, the face of Jesus, crowned with thorns and so many times slapped and covered with spit, the same face that Saint Veronica washed with her towel during the way of the cross. This meditation of the five wounds of Christ under all the sufferances of the Passion inspired so many artists and musicians, such as Dietrich Buxtehude, who took the prior of St. Bernard to write seven cantatas for choirs, one for each wound, and also Johann Sebastian Bach, who took from the meditation of St. Bernard some inspiration for the choirs of his St. Matthew's Passion. The devotion to the five wounds is an opportunity made to us to approach our Savior, humbly like St. Thomas, who firstly didn't believe, but then adored the mystery. Like newly born children, as we sang in the introit this morning, let's come to Jesus. We are all indeed newly born children with the grace of the baptism, which made us participating in the life of Jesus, this same life which he is having and maintain him constantly united with the Father and the Holy Ghost, the same life which is pushing us to come to him, to stay with him. Even the Gregorian melody of this beautiful introit is inviting us to lightness and joy, the same lightness and joy of the children running towards their father, towards their mother. The Gregorian mode used to ornate those beautiful and simple words is expressing the spiritual childhood that we must all feel and live in this Eastertide. We truly are like St. Thomas today, and our astonishment is marked even in the tune of the Kyrielle that we will sing all along Eastertide, showing our surprise before this incredible truth. Jesus is risen, and he showed himself to us. Firstly, we didn't want to admit it, but he showed himself to us. He asked us to come and see, contemplate, adore the wounds in his hands and his feet, to place our hand into his side, to receive from him the truth he wants out of his immense love to share with us. The Gregorian mode again in the Kyrielle is expressing our faith. As the melody stopped, it seemed that our prayer is continuing in silence and meditation. The communion antiphon that we will sing later in the Mass today is also taken from the word of Jesus himself. And again, we cannot hear in the melody any reproach from Jesus because of our lack of faith. We could imagine hearing these, a smiling father looking with tenderness at his son who couldn't believe the gift he was to receive. Come and put your hand and know the place of the nails, and be not faithless, but believing. Let's come to adore our divine Redeemer. He is there, victorious, expecting us like a father is expecting his child, ready to forgive him for the past offenses. Because he was dead, and now is alive again. Because he was lost, and he is found. He wants to bless us with his divine hands, marked with the nails. He wants to open the way to heaven, walking on his feet, marked with the same nails. He wants to share with us the furnace of charity from his heart. He's there, upon the cross above our altar. His feet are attached. He's waiting for us. His arms are extended. He wants to welcome all of us. His side is opened. He wants to share with us a treasure of grace. His crowned head is bowing towards us. He wants to give us a sign of peace and reconciliation. Jesus is waiting to give us his divine blessing. In the name of the Father, of the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Thank you.
Confiteor Deo omnipotentim, Beate Marie Semper Virgin, Beatum Michaeli Arcangelo, Beate Ioanni Baptiste, Sanctis Apostolis Petro et Paolo, Omnibus Sanctis et Tibi Pater, Quia peccavi nimis cogitatione verbo et opere, mea culpa, mea maxima culpa. Idio precor Beata Mariam semper Virgin, Beatum Michaelem Arcangelum, Beatum Ioannem Baptista, Sanctus Apostolos Petrum et Paulum, omnes sanctos et te Pater. Orare pro me ad Dominum Deum nostrum.
Miserere nostri omnipotens Deus, et in missis peccatis vestris per pecos adicum et
eterna. Amen.
Indulgentiam absolutiam in et remissionem peccatorum vestrorum, qui per pecus omnipotens et misericors Dominus. Equitori peccata mundi. Domine nos, nimis,
nimis, rectum me,
satantum fervor senat panorama me. Domine nos, nimis, nimis, rectum me, satantum fervor senat panorama me. Domine nos, nimis, nimis, rectum me, satantum fervor senat panorama me.
Thank you.
Et Spiritus Sanctus. Per Christum Dominum nostrum.